have a welcome to the one and only Vaughn Jensen, ladies and gentlemen. Vaughn Jensen here on a Monday night.
Thank you.
talked about some of your inspirations. When you write original music, how does that come to you? I heard a couple of instrumentals in there and some Give Me Wings. I like that one too. You Got a Man That'll Toe the Line. You got some strong songs in there.
Those songs are Give Me Wings, of course. It's just, you know, everybody gets a little frustrated with life sometimes, want to give up. And Give Me Wings is just Give Me Wings to get up over that next time, get on to the next level where I need to be in life. And then Toe the Line and Satisfied Me. And a lot of these songs are inspired by my wife, who stands beside my side and supports my music full-heartedly and allows me to travel. We're in 6 different states now. I'll be going back to Reno this in a couple of weeks here. It's really what I like is just getting out and introducing myself to the musicians and making new fans, and my family and my God love me to do that. My band too. Great band.
I'm talking about growing up in your youth. Was there someone who inspired you, like a dad or a grandma or some relative or part of your family?
I was actually a late bloomer. I always wanted to play music, but I didn't pick it up till I was nearly 20. Picked up guitar, started singing in a band, and I told the guy at the time that I was also a guitar player, but I wasn't really a guitar player. I just wanted to be one. So 19 to 20, I got my real interest in it, and then you know, just many inspirational people over the year. A lot of the great, you know, Kevin Sutton's one of my favorite guitar players here at the Wired Band. Mark Riley's another great guitar player. C.D. Woodbury, Clint's a great guitar player. There's so many. My heroes are all right here, local musicians. You know, all my right over here on the north end of Seattle. A'Ron Jones, another one of my heroes on the guitar. So I'm happy to see him here tonight.
Giving shout outs everywhere. A very humble man here standing next to me. And that's part of the good design of the blues, you know, is the humbleness of it all.
Yeah.
about some of your teachers. Do you have teachers, or is this self-taught stuff?
I'm a self-taught musician, as much as you can be in this world. You know, just like everybody else, I listen to people that I was influenced by. I'm still being influenced by musicians every day. A year or so ago, a couple of years ago, I had the pleasure of meeting some of the younger musicians coming up in the blues, Aaron Jones, Cody Rantis, Cody Beebe, and a lot of the young, finer musicians coming up. I sure haven't named just a few, but Aaron is particularly who really opened my eyes to the harder rock side of the blues, and it kind of opened up a new thing for me. I'm trying to keep up with the time, so I'm keeping my eye on the younger men in the blues. So my inspirations are actually younger. Of course, you can hear B.B. King and Stevie Ray and all the others in there, but they're all inspired, just like the young kids that are coming up today. They're all inspired the same, so I'm looking to the next generation for my blues.
Some of that, were you influenced by any family members, or what inspired you there?
I had a troubled upbringing. I'm angry. BB King, Stevie Ray Vaughan, I love the way they sing and pronounce the vocals. I kind of holler my vocals, you know, get it out there so you can hear it. Yeah. We got a big mouth, I say.
Have you always had a big mouth?
Not always. I used to try to sing pretty, but the mirror I got that wasn't working for me, so I had to just change up. Nasty image.
Yeah. Well, it takes a lot to sing in front of people. That's alone a skill that you have to develop besides the guitar player. So tell me about both of those skills. How'd you get into both?
Well, for a while I had a six-piece. I built all the way up to a six-piece, and financially things have gotten tough. Everybody knows that it's gotten harder on the economy and whatnot. And so to scale down, I scaled it back down to a three-piece to try and make a little more money at it and to try and work a little more and to make myself more appealing to smaller venues.
Well, now, original music, that's also pretty daring of you. Tell me about your original songs. That first one I really like. I didn't get the name of it. I didn't write it down. So tell me the first one.
I think I started out with Someday Maybe His Grace Over Me. It's coming off of my new album, Grace, that I recorded at Chip Butter Sound Studios. It's going to be a great song. It's just basically, you know, one day maybe His Grace will come over me. But it does all the time, every day. I'm living the American dream. So I'm not rich, but I'm rich in love and family and friends. Doing good.
Yeah, I feel like that works too. Yes. You're a spiritual guy, aren't you?
I'm practicing. Yeah, every day is a practice.
But give it up one more time. Vaughn Jensen, all the way from Tri-Cities.
You guys can catch our schedule out on Facebook, too, at the Vaughn Jensen Band on Facebook.